Bases clearing triple to tie the game. That Madison Youngerner was hit with a pitch. It just grazed his pant leg. He's all
the
right.
Dish for the
and here comes the hottest hitter in the American Association,
six,
Logan Landon.
Logan Landon.
Righty on righty here. Brett is on third. Youngerner on first. Landon is the 11th batter to come to the plate in this third inning.
And outside of the two-run home run by Andrew Ely, all of this has come with two outs.
An astute observation, Adam. You're absolutely right. And it was frustrating for Goosen Brown, who has left the game. Jalen Miller is on to replace him for the Chicago Dogs. Hard-throwing right-hander. He pitches, and Landon takes away on a first-pitch slider, and the count is 1-0. On the season, Miller with a 4.45 ERA. This is his 28th appearance of the year. He's been a real workhorse for the Chicago Dogs team this year. 40 strikeouts against 15 balls, but walks, I should say. The 1-0, fastball low at 93. Two balls, no strikes. He's thrown 32 and a third innings of work. Hitters are batting 200 against him. Tied at six, bottom of the third. Landon reached on an error his first time up. His last time up was earlier this inning. He reached on an infield single to extend his hitting streak. Pitch is just on the outside corner. Fastball at 95, nothing, but Landon could have done with that. Two balls and a strike. Youngerner taking a somewhat aggressive lead over at first base. More aggressive than, say, Jabari Henry would over there. The 2-1 pitch outside with another fastball, three balls and a strike. That one missed the target. It looked like Lidge was setting up on the inner half and reached out to grab it on the outer half there. There's more good news from St. Paul, by the way. Chris Chenea just hit a home run. The 3-1 pitch to Logan Landon. Swing and a miss, high heater at 94, 3-2. Wow, two-run homer, I believe, Chris Chenea. It's 7-0 Saints in the fifth inning at CHS Field. Again, the Canaries need a win and a Saints win to make the playoffs today. And Mitchell Lamson, one of the best pitchers this league has ever seen, is not having a great day for the Goldeyes. Payoff pitch, Youngerner goes, pitches foul back. I think you can tell, at least from being up here, and we've talked to him about this, you can tell Madison Youngerner's enjoying this, being able to be a position player for this Birds team, and knowing that he's contributing at the plate. He's putting some good swings. He's looked really good in batting practice. And he'll be going on this next 3-2. The pitch. Swing and a miss. Got him. Blew a 95-mile-per-hour fastball by Logan Landon. That's a really important out for Jalen Miller and the Chicago Dogs. But the Birds tie the score. Six runs in inning number three for the Sioux Falls Canaries.
Welcome back to Sioux Falls, bottom of the fourth, tied at six, Chicago and Sioux Falls. Andrew Ely lines the first pitch down the right field line, fair ball into the right field corner. He rounds first, takes a big turn, but holds up as the ball came in quickly. A leadoff single for Andrew Ely.
Great job from Victor Roche out in right field to play that ball off the wall. He looks like a Canary veteran making that play. Fielding the ricochet, that ball was scorched down the right field line. And how big will that turn out to be to prevent an extra base hit?
Andrew Ely's seen too many of those plays on a defensive side, so
yeah,
he knew he should just hold up. Here's Quinn Coulter. He takes the first pitch high.
It's true, he's tagged a lot of guys out who decided to try and push their luck on balls to right field.
A lot of the time, it's been because of the guy at the plate, Quinn Coulter. The 1-0 misses inside, two balls and no strikes. Leon first with nobody out. Tied at six, bottom of the fourth. Canaries batted around in the bottom of the third to score all six of their runs. The 2-0. This is outside, 3-0 now. Miller comes set. Kicks and fires a 3-0, and Coulter was taking all the way. And therefore, strike 3-1. The 3-1. Coulter swings through a high fastball on the outside part of the plate at 95.
Yeah, if you're going to throw Clint Coulter a fastball, that is how you do it. You throw gas and you keep it way up above the zone so he can't get on top of it.
Payoff pitch upcoming to Clint Coulter. Payoff is fouled straight back and out of play. Ely at first after his leadoff single. The 3-2 lifted to center field. Kraus trots over to his left. It's carrying, but he makes the grab a few steps in front of the warning track for out number one.
Deepest part of the yard out there. This is one of those nights where every fly ball like that, you watch that one all the way through before you put the fly out in your scorebook. We've seen players on the Canaries and on other teams get caught up when there's a last second gust of wind. That time, Kraus does a great job making the play.
Here's Damek Tomche, one out, tied at six, Ely on first. Tomche looks at strike one, 95 from Jalen Miller. He singled and scored his last time up in the third. The 0-1 skips in the dirt. One ball and one strike.
No! Oh, Mayhew!
They said he went.
What are you watching?
Winds are off right now. Come on, buddy.
Okay, 0-2 on Clint, on Damek Tomche.
Mayhew Edwards, the crew chief over at first base.
The 0-2 swung on and missed. Hold the string on him, and down goes Tomche on three pitches. Now Ole Lago, two outs, Ely at first. Tied at six. Lago doubled and scored in the third. First pitch to Lago, misses outside. A ball and no strikes. He hit a bouncer back to Goose and Brown in the second inning. Lago. 1-0, misses low. Ends up in the dirt. Two balls and no strikes. Now we're set. The 2-0 taken on the inside edge. Two balls and a strike. The 2-1, swung on and missed. Blew the fastball right by him that time, 2-2.
So difficult when Miller is throwing strikes and changing speeds the way he can.
Ely at first, two gone. The 2-2 to Lago. And he watches ball three miss high.
Ooh, I think he may have thought that was ball four. Taps his chest, says, that's on me. Started walking toward first base and then realized, oh, sorry, it's 3-2. Ely running here.
Miller set for the payoff. Ely takes off. The payoff is outside for ball four. Lago draws a two-out walk to put runners on first and second.
Loving the patience from the Canaries. It's kind of interesting. Mike Meyer said that Chicago was going to be really patient at the plate, so it was going to be important for Anderson to pour strikes in. But the Birds have been really patient at the plate tonight as well, or this afternoon, or whatever you want to call it. And no one has been more patient and seen the ball better, I think, than this guy, Jabari Henry.
Two long at-bats so far this afternoon. It was rewarded with a single in the second. Drew a walk and scored his last time up. First pitch is waved at and missed on the first pitch slider. Two on, two outs, tied at six, bottom of the fourth. A big lead for Andrew Ely, and now Miller steps off and walks him back. Now Lidge will trot out and have a word with Jalen Miller. This is a big at-bat. Jabari Henry, we talked about him seeing the ball well. Well, he's seen the ball well his last few games. And everyone knows when Jabari Henry is settled in, he's very dangerous with the bat. The 0-1, Henry takes up and in. A ball and a strike. Ely on second, Lago aboard first. The 1-1, Henry swings through. Change up. 1-2. Miller's ready, the 1-2, and he misses low, 2-2. Tied at six, 9 hits for Chicago, 8 for the Birds, and 1 error for Chicago. The 2-2 is swung through and missed. High heater from Jalen Miller, and Henry goes down swinging for out number three. So the Birds leave a pair of runs. Put up
coming
nothing
to the plate.
In the top half of this inning.
Your first baseman, number 20.
Now it's the Birds' turn.
Make some noise for Mike Hart.
And the crowd here just got an announcement from Randy Presti of the Stadium PA with the Coca-Cola out-of-town scoreboard confirming that it's still 7-0 St. Paul. Nice round of applause from the crowd here at the Birdcage.
First pitch to Hart is swung on and missed.
Such a good changeup.
The 0-1. This is outside. One ball and one strike. Hart drew a bases loaded walk his last time up. Eventually came around to score. 1-1 misses low. 2-1. He also has a single in this game. The 2-1 swung on and missed. Up in the zone, 2-2. And it'll wind up the 2-2. Up and away for ball three. The payoff to Mike Hart. and it hits him on the leg. You know, trot down to first.
Well, he extends his league lead. That got him right on the thigh. Not a terrible place to get plunked. At least for me, I'm holding my breath every time there's a hit batter. We saw two players, one from each team, leave
at the dish, your
with
left
injuries after
number
being
one,
hit with pitches last
make
night.
Some
but Mike
noise
Hart
for
is
Ryan Brett.
Built like a truck, and he appears to be all right.
So here's Ryan Brett at the big hit his last time up. A three-run, bases-clearing triple. He squares the bunt, pops it up off the screen. Foul. Tied at six in the bottom of the fifth. Birds get their leadoff man on by the hit by pitch. The 0-1 swung on and missed. 0-2 on Brett.
Well, Kevin Fullman is running out to the bullpen right now.
The 0-2, and Brett swings through a high fastball for strike three. The first out here in the fifth.
That might be to deliver a message about who should be getting loose out there. That might be it for Fullman after two productive innings. And Nico Blank is starting to throw for the Canaries. So message received.
Here's Madison Youngener, and he takes the first pitch. Foul out of play left side.
He got a fastball over the plate, and he hit that ball a long way, but foul.
Youngener has popped out and was grazed by a pitch. It's last time up. And Hart is checked on and back in without a slide. No balls and a strike. Tied at six. Hart on first. One out. The 0-1. This is low and inside. 1-1. Two in the first for Chicago, one more in the second, and three more in the third. Jump out to the big 6-0 lead. As Youngener watches the ball skip back to the backstop, Hart and takes second. Now it takes a big turnaround second. Thought about going to third, but he will slam on the brakes.
He did think about it. He almost did it, but not quite. You know, and that's something worth thinking about because you do gain a lot taking that extra base at third with one man out. It'll just take the one on the wild pitch.
Six nothing Chicago until Birds tied it up. With six in the bottom of the third. 2-1 to Youngener. This is low and inside. Three balls and a strike. Logan Landon on deck.
Well, we should see a good pitch here. Very protected in Miss Bird's lineup, Madison Youngener.
Long pause from Jalen Miller. He took a peek back at Hart. Just held the set before Youngener called time. He is set again. A 3-1. And therefore strike two. Good pitch right at the knees at 93. Three balls and two strikes. The payoff to Youngener. Youngener fouls it straight back right to our left. heads up.
Of course, the one time I'm taking the photo of the pretty sky for Instagram, I think was 2 feet to my left. I think Luke Martin, our camera operator today, probably was the one that was the most spooked. That was probably coming right into your living room.
The payoff. Foul tipped, just got a piece of it, and it got a piece of Lynch behind the plate. Is that the closest a ball has ever gotten?
Oh yeah, no doubt.
Chicago Trainer is out to.
Yeah, it looked like that got him below the belt. Lidge, the catcher. If this is one where you walk it off, you take some time. This has got to be interesting for both Miller and Younginer here. This is a long plate appearance. Count is full. It's a big spot. Tie game at six. Man in scoring position with one out. Of course, Madison Younginer, he already has an RBI. RBI double against the Chicago Dogs back in August. August the 2nd, to be exact. So this is not, you know, I know he's the pitcher coming in here with, to fill the spots, but this is certainly far from a walkover here. He can deliver for the Birds.
Lidge stays in the ball game. Miller comes set once again. The 3-2. Swung on and missed. Pulled the string on Younginer, and he was way out in front of it. First strike, number three, and out number two.
Five strikeouts for Miller, and he's used all of his pitches to get those. By my unofficial count, he's got three on the fastball, one each on the curve and the change now.
And now here comes Butch Hobson out of the dugout. And that was Jalen Miller's last batter. Be a new arm to face Logan Landon when we return on the Canaries Radio Network and AABaseball.tv.